motivated.
Get motivated.
Get motivated. Hip hop motivated. Blowing wisdom on the mic with Sean.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, interesting. We are now in hour two of Flow of Wisdom Radio. Of course, I'm your host, Sean Anthony, and the subject matter is transhumanism, quantum computing, parallel universes, 2045 initiative, artificial intelligence, all of the above, advanced technology. That's what we are discussing today. And I tell you, this has been a very, very interesting series. It's only not only taught me a lot, but it's given me a great new perspective on a lot of things. But you know, Miss Judy from Florida called in just at the end of this first hour. She brought up some really great points, and you know, I'm all a proponent in believing that we're in a spiritual battle. This is a spiritual warfare. It's between good and evil for sure. And she was also right when she mentioned that the realm of the unseen realm in which we cannot physically see, is more real than this physical realm that we see. I believe that things are created from the invisible realm. When you think about it, you know, I was just reading an article, and man, I got so much information in front of me. It's just kind of difficult to kind of keep it all in one place, but it was a physicist talking about when they were looking to the microscope at atoms or what have you. It moves, but then when they turn away, it changes format into like a wave. But then when you look at it again, its actions are different when you look at it. And just think about it. Just think about thought. You know how they say mind over matter? When you put focus on a particular thought to manifest something, there's something intangible that cannot be explained that happens in the unseen realm in which we live that creates manifestation of that thought in our head to come up to fruition. I hope I'm making sense to you guys. I mean, come on, y'all. For example, if you think of somebody you went to school with and you haven't talked to them in a long time, and next thing you know, you go out to a restaurant, boom, you run into them at the restaurant. There's certain things that happen in the universe that we have control, that we can influence and have control over in our mind and our thought process. That's really, really fascinating. You know, when I went to break, I read some emails. Flowofwisdom.com. You can definitely reach out to me that way. But Leroy in Atlanta wrote to me. He says, so wait a minute. Let me get this straight. Are you saying that computers can be better than humans at being human? And that question, that's a great question, Leroy. But that question reminds me of the scene with, what's the name of the movie starring Matt Damon? And what is the name of that movie? It escapes me right now. But they, planet Earth is just infected with disease and all of this stuff. And they got the place right out of space that can heal all the sicknesses and diseases and stuff like that. But anyway, he goes to the DMV or whatever this place, his social worker, his caseworker, but the caseworker is a robot, a droid. And the robot is talking to Matt Damon's character. You know, are you upset? And he's like, no. And the computer's like, well, I'm detecting elevated heart levels. Do you need prescription drugs? Do you need your drugs? He's like, no, I don't need the drugs, but you're getting upset. I'm not upset. Well, I'm detecting your heartbeat is, you know, there's no, human tangible, essence of a human being when you have these creations of robots trying to act as if they are human. Anyway, 877 300 7645. Let's get these phone calls in. We have Stuart in Florida. We get a lot of callers in Florida. This is good. Stuart, what are your thoughts on parallel universes, Stuart? Welcome to Flow of Wisdom.
Oh, how you doing Mr. R. Anthony?
Good.
It's good to hear from you. Thank you for your show. Just kind of wanted to add on to what Ms. Judy said about the parallel universes. And it's always spiritual, like you say, and so much all there to discuss, and it is seen, but see, it all still goes back to the Word of God. That is His love letter to us. All the answers can be found in there, but see, that's why they're trying to reject the Bible. To put it in perspective, let's say there's 1,000 parallel universes, and you can go to every one of them. Your body and soul gonna go with you, and your sin. See, man is trying to get round sin. His sin is gonna follow. So if he could go there, there have to be no God. If there's no sin, and man wants to be his own God and just keep living, and God made him his creator, and all these universes and parallel are still limited to time, space, and matter. But God is outside of all of that. He's eternal, dwelling in eternity. And you can't get around God. But man wants to live in his sin. They said he loved darkness rather than light. That's why when you read your Bible, you begin to see. But see, the enemy has the power. He even offered Jesus these kingdoms, and he's still offering kingdoms. But see, this is where he throws in deception. Oh, there's another parallel universe, and oh, you can have all this and this and that. He's the father of lies, just like how he tell the Muslims, you're going to have 72 virgins. But where are they going to get the food from? And you go to the other universes, who are you going to worship? We was made to worship. If not, like that guy say, if that light not lit, you're dead already. See, so what they want to do is to live without God, but they can't put that light out because they're using his own energy into. But watch this. This last little thing I want to say. But just imagine the dunamis power of Holy Ghost, that one atom, he holds it together. All his laws of gravity, quantum physics, thermonuclear, he holds it together. Now imagine if he were to let it go, what would happen? Mm-hmm.
Or if you just changed one number, one decimal.
That's right. Yeah. Now he holds it together. That takes power. Now what if he just, he let man split it? But see, these fallen angels are deceiving man, like with Flash, you see all that stuff, so they can have these powers, but they're still in their sin. Mm-hmm. You see them hop in the bed, they don't even ask about condoms, yeah. They're having babies out of wedlock. See, the world, when you wrap up all the government and everything else, this world was built of blood off the Indians. Look at all of the aborted babies, and we want a piece of this world. This world is drowning in its own filth. But see, he could have got rid of the devil and blanked it out. But no, he said he's going to let sin take its full course. And now we are at the end. And now here we are. And Jesus is the only way. And guess what I told you? He's guarding the door. At least men's eyes should be open. And that's what it's all about. That's why he's trying to get rid of the Bible. That's why you need to stay right there. But see, he's trying to get everybody's eyes off this and all these unlearned questions. Yeah. Like I said, you can't even put your emotions under a telescope and read it, but it's there.
It's there. See, it's there. It's the intangibles.
Knowledge puffs up, and man wants to know instead of knowing the creator, which is a relationship. But see, science is a religion, and they want to serve themselves. That's all that. Just to see on that.
All right, Stuart in Florida. Thanks for the call, man. Always a pleasure to hear from you. You know, it's interesting. Stuart brought up some good points. It made me think about, you know, when I was telling you guys at the beginning of this series about certain people, there was an article talking about the obsession with curing aging, how it's big business now. And I mentioned a list of individuals and gave some information on each. Peter Thiel was the one. He's the co-founder of PayPal. He's also a Donald Trump supporter, but he invested over $3.5 million for this Methuselah Foundation to the research. This anti-aging researcher, his name is Aubrey de Grey, and not only that, his firm, his venture capital firm, they've been investing in at least 14 health and biotech companies that are all focused on extending life through medicine. Like, and a lot of these other guys, like Bill Maris, Arthur Levinson, Craig Venter, who I mentioned, he's known for creating artificial life. He created artificial life. But all of these people that like that are into this stuff, they're looking to the same principles that the scriptures talk about. And I said this, if you go back and listen to the beginning of this series, I broke it down and I talked about how these people are doing. I'll take another quick call. Do we have time or are we about to go to a commercial break? We're all right. We're about to go to break. All right. I'm going to come back. I have three calls on the line. I'm going to get to you guys. So please hang in there. Stay right there. We'll take a quick break. But, you know, one thing before I go, before we take a quick break. The parallel universes, you heard what Dr. Jordy said, the co-founder of D-Wave Systems. You heard his predictions that these intelligent machines are going to be in existence and being able to do everything humans can do. Look, don't go anywhere. We'll be back with your calls right after this. It's Flow of Wisdom Radio. I promise you I have the best listeners in talk radio. Welcome back. Flow of Wisdom Radio. I'm your host, Sean Anthony. The name of that Matt Damon movie I could not think of is called Elysium. If you go back and watch that movie, you'll see a lot of the information that we've been talking about in this series is here. And also, you'll see that scene that I was playing out. But 877-300-7645. I'm going to get to these callers real quick. I wanted to read this information. An interesting article that came out in ScienceAlert.com. A cosmologist says he found possible signs of a parallel universe. And, you know, the excerpt in that particular article that I wanted to share with you was the fact that, oh man, that's not the one. That is not the one. I am sorry. Ah, forgive me, guys. Ah, man. Anyway, I'll come back to it. Let's go to Leroy. Leroy in Atlanta wants to talk about the Mandela effect. Leroy, welcome to Flow of Wisdom.
What's going on, SA? Once again, y'all hitting it out the park.
Appreciate it, man. Thanks.
But, even worse is that, you know, what is shown in these movies and what is subliminally or overtly stated is done intentionally to desensitize. So events, laws, or whatever is easily digested by the masses. Mm-hmm. And Judy, I mean, a lot of everything she was saying was right, but I definitely want to add this. And it's not so much that it's a parallel universe. It's the spirit world.
Mm-hmm.
It's the spirit world. And, you know, it's two directions when you get there. And everybody's going to one place or the other. And it's not a matter to me that Satan has power, because greater is he that is in me than he that is in the world.
In the world, yep. Absolutely.
So we got to always keep that in mind, but I just a little off topic, but I got to get this in. So you remember the Zarnell brother that got caught at Boston, right?
Yeah, talking about the Boston bombing?
Yeah, yeah. He was asleep on the boat.
Right.
The guy they just caught out in Jersey for what he did, he was asleep in front of a bar.
In Manhattan?
Yeah. Him, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
This person that just did this, what, in Washington, was he asleep when they caught him, too?
I don't know, but that whole thing in Manhattan just sounds fishy to me, man.
I mean, something happened. Something happened. We know something happened. False flag do not mean people don't die. False flag mean they lying about what happened.
For their agenda. Thanks, Leroy, man. I got to run. Get these
other
calls.
All right, y'all keep praying.
Yes, sir. Leroy in Atlanta. I found that article, guys, and forgive me. It was out of physics.org, and it's the title of it is called Strange Behavior of Quantum Particles May Indicate the Existence of Other Parallel Universes. This was published June 3rd of 2015, and here's a quick excerpt real quick. It says the Texas Tech University professor of chemistry and biochemistry said that quantum mechanics is a strange realm of reality. Particles at this atomic and subatomic level can appear to be in two places at once. Because the activity of these particles is so iffy, scientists can only describe what's happening mathematically by quote unquote drawing the tiny landscape as a wave of probability. I just thought that was interesting. Let's go to Kansas City. We have Salahuddin. I hope I pronounced your name correct. Kansas City, Missouri wants to talk about parallel universes. Did I pronounce your name right?
Yes, you did a great job, Sean. Thank you very much for accepting my. You have a great show, man.
Thank you. I appreciate it, man. What are your thoughts on this?
First of all, I wanted to say, with the name of God, most gracious, most merciful, there's nothing greater than God. Okay? I wanted to read a passage out of the Quran that deals with what we're talking about here, and it says, "And recall when your Lord said to the angels, I am, according to my usual practice, going to appoint a supreme religious head in the land, and to execute my will in the universe. They said, will you create also therein something that will cause disorder and shed blood while we glorify you and celebrate your praise? And God answered to them and said, I know what you know not. And he taught Adam the nature of all things. And he told the angels, he said, and when I form him and breathe of him, breathe into him of my nature, I want you to bow down and do submission to him. And all of the angels did so except for Iblis, the leader of the angels, who really wasn't an angel.
Wait a minute. Hold on. Stay right there. Salahuddin, we got to take a quick break. We'll come back to your call right after this message. Don't go anywhere. This is Flow of Wisdom Radio. All right. Welcome back to Flow of Wisdom Radio. Sean Anthony here. Let's go back to Kansas City. With Salahuddin. Salahuddin, before we went to break, you were mentioning something that all the angels bowed down except for one.
He really wasn't an angel. That's why he didn't bow down. He was referred to as Iblis, who later became Satan. He was the head of the angels, but he didn't realize that he wasn't an angel. He didn't find out that he wasn't an angel until the Creator told all of the angels to bow down to the human being. See, this whole universe makes no sense without the human being. The human intellect is the gift of God to this entire creation. So Iblis mentioned to God, he said, well, you made him of mud, and you made me of fire. And he's not good enough for me to bow down to. So he became the opponent of the human creature. He wasn't an opponent of God. He already knew, just like in Job, it bears witness that Satan had to ask God for the opportunity to attack Job. He said, and God told him, he said, you can have your way with him, but don't kill him, mm-hmm. if I remember it correctly.
Right.
So the reality of this situation is that the human creature, we are the thought of God, capable of thinking in third-dimensional reality, aware of itself.
Gotcha.
There's nothing in this universe that is superior to the human creature.
Well said,
the
man.
The human creature could become worse than the lowest animal on the planet.
Mm-hmm.
We're the top of the food chain. We can make a sandwich out of anything moving on this planet or anything that we come in contact with. Just kind of light talk. But
gotcha.
The reality is, my brother, that we are coming to the time when this evil, wicked mentality, because man means mind. Man, we're not physical beings. The physical is just the
outer exterior.
Creation. So yeah, the lady was right. There's more to the unseen than it is to the seen.
Right. Absolutely,
but,
man.
But praise be to God, we're waking up. We're waking up. And if we allow these people to keep feeding us these poison foods and poison our water and continue to destroy our humanity, fluoride calcifies the pineal gland,
mm-hmm.
which is right in the center of the brain, which the scientists say is the third eye or the seat to human spirituality. And then we wonder why our children are so ungodlike.
Mm-hmm.
If I can use this term, Sean, please let me. I don't mean it derogatory, but we got to declare jihad. The real jihad is on the nigger that exists in us. Excuse my language. We got to declare jihad on that, because that's not a real. That was placed in us by a white mind. That's not us. That's a construction of the Caucasian mentality that gave us the image of God in white flesh. And,
right.
and all the angels are Caucasian, and all the prophets and everything that we see is Caucasian, to make us feel inferior and to make them feel superior. And I'm not saying anything against good, because there's some good Caucasian people. There's some good people. And I don't like to use the term white and black. I'm an artist, and I couldn't paint a picture of a African American person with black paint, just like I couldn't paint a picture of a Caucasian person with ivory white paint.
Gotcha.
You understand what I'm saying?
Yeah, but let me get to these other callers, man. I appreciate the call. This is your first time calling Kansas City. I appreciate it, Salahuddin. You have a good one, man.
Thank you very much. You too, man.
All right, now peace. Let's go to Chicago. Robert X. Robert X, I'm anticipating what you have to say in regards to the parallel universe and also Stranger Things. Robert X, good to hear from you, sir.
Hotep, Brother Sean. One of the things you won't hear is me basically elucidating on the various religions. It's like dueling religions, okay? I'm not going to go there. I don't have a problem with people having their faith. I just have a problem with people and their facts. Brother Sean, for you and the listeners, if you want to go in-depth into understanding the relationship between people and the drinking of blood, which is an age-old construct, goes way back, there's a book called Mummies, Cannibals, and Vampires by Richard Sugg, and it deals with the history of what's called corpse medicine. Corpse medicine, okay? And this book basically deals with the era from the Renaissance to the Victorian, quite a long time, couple hundred years, where the ritual of drinking blood, which is manifested in the Christian religion particularly, okay, through the eating of the flesh and the drinking of the blood, symbolically, okay, this thing has a much longer history than people who have faith but don't have the facts really want to deal with. They like to stay comfortable, so they don't venture outside what they've been told. But if there's something wrong with research, then you shouldn't have a problem going to a plumber to have heart surgery. Because everything that we know is predicated on research.
Right.
Everything. Okay? Now, let's stay here, Brother Sean, because your subject matter is extremely important. You mentioned Elysium. You can go and look up the definition of Elysium. You'll find that that term was used to describe heaven. Am I still here?
Yes, sir. I hear you.
Okay. Okay. That term was used to describe heaven, okay? That was the place during ancient times where the heroes, Hercules and all those people come from out of Greek mythology. That's where they went after their demise. to live an eternal life. And that's why you saw an off-world parallel system presided over by LGBT, while the masses of the people were stuck in abject poverty on Earth, okay? And that's what's being set up right now. You see the same thing where the children are sacrificed on a ritual, an annual ritualistic basis in the Hunger Games. Once the North American Union is put in place after a major war that we're on the verge of right now, all being facilitated by people who engage in social doctrines or social engineering. But let's go to Stranger Things, because that's extremely important. Stranger Things is basically dealing with MK Ultra, okay?
Mm-hmm.
Which basically came out of the Montauk Project. And what happens is there's a little girl that's the center of the television series named Eleven.
Mm-hmm.
And they call her El, which is short for God, okay? Because she has certain telekinetic and psychokinetic powers that allow her to go beyond the realm of the frequencies that we exist on into what they term the parallel universe, but what's really the Kelipot. The Kelipot, Q-L-I-P-H-O-T-H. Look it up, family. And you will find that the Kelipot is, in fact, the alternative universe on the planet, okay? Planetary-wise, because it basically deals with the Sephira, the ten emanations, and the Kabbalah that allow for people to attain their spiritual heightenedness, okay? But there's an alternative to it, a parallel to it, that has 10 emanations as well, but they basically represent the opposite of what the 10 Sephira represent in the Kabbalah. So she has access to the Kelipot, okay? She has access to this, and because of that, she's able to transcend. But keep in mind now, this is all dealing with MK Ultra, a real program out of the Montauk Project, which dealt with mind control, time travel, and even in opening up black holes going all the way back to the 1940s,
mm-hmm.
Okay? And this is what I've been meaning, Brother Sean, for the people to understand, in that you have to understand not just the times that we exist in, but where this stuff comes from. And when you go back and do the research, you'll find that it comes out of Aleister Crowley through Jack Parsons in the JPL laboratory and NASA. Through the Church of Scientology, in Hollywood, okay, where it's now being manifested on television in just about every area that you can name, particularly politics, because many of the people engaged in politics globally are heavily involved in the occult. I'll leave you with this. It's no small coincidence that the Arch of Triumph, which is dedicated to the Temple of Baal, okay, was just recently opened up, and it, too, is in the form of the number 11. It represents a doorway, a gateway, and all these gateways were opened over the past couple of months that allow for these entities, and for people who don't know, a scientist from CERN named Dr. Ruggiero Santilli basically introduced a new technology using a convex lens instead of a concave lens that allows for them to, in fact, see in this realm that we exist on, the seven frequencies, allowed them to see entities that exist at these other frequency levels, okay, with the quantum computer, the D-Wave, the 2045 adiabatic computer that I mentioned to you some time ago. It will allow for them, using CERN, to, in fact, and this is what they're doing now, this is why you have parallel universes opening up and things changing right before our eyes, because it allows for the system of ones and zeros to exist in the same place at the same time.
At the same time, yes.
And so that's what's going on. They're opening up doorways, but the elite globally are participating in this by accelerating the process through opening up things like the Gotha Tunnel and the Temples to Baal that they call the Arch of Triumph. that will lead you directly to what Donald Trump really represents. And I won't drop that on the family. I'll say that for next communication so that somebody else can get on the line, my brother.
You know, real quick, Robert X, great points. I just want to let the listeners know, Stranger Things is a new television series on Netflix. And it was, you know, from an entertainment perspective, because, of course, I look at it with my eyes wide open, okay? And from an entertainment perspective, the show takes place in the 80s. And the details that they have in that TV series is unbelievable. But the young kids that act in it, they're phenomenal in it. But man, when you watch it and hear the storyline, listen to everything that Robert X just said, it will blow your mind away. Robert X, always a pleasure, sir. Thank you, man. Look forward to talking to you. Yes, sir. Peace. All right, we're going to take a quick break, guys. When we come back, I'll take some more calls right after this. This is Floor Wisdom Radio. Welcome back to a live edition of Flow of Wisdom Radio. Sean Anthony here talking about quantum computing, parallel universes, and so much more. 877-300-7645. Let's go to Ohio. Don in Ohio, what are your thoughts on the parallel universe discussion? Don, welcome to Flow of Wisdom.
Oh, yes, and I'm going to try to get through as quickly as possible. Well, I just like to say, first of all, there's fact, there's fiction, and we can go in and call fantasy. I don't want to use this as an analogy. In World War II, when the Nazis took over Germany, they practiced something that the communists do. It's called reconstruction. Reconstruction is when you get rid of all the history that preceded you, and you even teach people to despise their history. So they burn all the books of religion, they burn all the books of history and all this type of thing. And what they embraced was the Aryan nation, which was totally a fantasy. They actually even looked for this Aryan nation. It came from mythology. But what the Nazis did, they involved themselves in Satanism, demonic worship. And as you look at them, as far as their scientists, they were brilliant. They were the first ones to come up with rocket propulsion. They were the first ones to come up with jet propulsion. They had all these weaponries that were superior to everybody that was in the world. Now, after the war, they were given immunity, many of the Nazi scientists, and a lot of people don't know this. America brought Nazi scientists to America, and they helped us in our space program because they were ahead in rocket propulsion. But when they asked them this question, they said, "Where did you all get this technology?" Here's where their answer. They said, "We got it from aliens." Now, I grant you, they didn't get it from aliens. They got it from demonic spirits posing as aliens. And that's what happens when you don't have the God element and the God factor coupled with scientists. When people don't believe in God, they don't believe he was the creator, that he was an intelligent being. And the fact is, man seeks out many inventions. And that's what you're looking at when you look at a lot of science. See, everything that's written down, what people need to understand, everything that's written down doesn't mean it's a fact. Everything that's in print doesn't mean it's true. And the Bible talks about doctrines of devils. The word doctrine means teachings. See, people think that demons are spooky, but demon spirits are very intelligent. And I'll give you the reason why I say that, because the Bible says Satan himself was sealed and summed up with wisdom. And just because something is articulate, just because something seems a scientific fact and comes from an intelligent premise, doesn't mean it's true, because that's the deception. There's nothing outside of God, because God is the creator of mankind, and everything that we discover in science is something that God has already created. Unless we use our imagination to take it into another realm. See, and that's what happens in science when science is gone away. And some things that you read in print is science gone away. They will never take the consciousness of a human being and put it in a machine. And I said this before, when you traumatize the body, we are triunity. We're body, soul, and spirit. If you traumatize the body, the spirit, the soul leaves, because death is when the soul leaves the body.
body. That's what natural death is. Spiritual death is alienated from God. And when a person comes into this world, they are alienated from God. And I gave this example, I gave it last week. You look at a person's soul, they're within that body. It's like a candle. When that candle was lit, that is the illumination and consciousness back to God that only comes through a born-again experience. But when a person is walking around without God in their life and a born-again experience, you are a living dead person. You are walking around full of darkness, and you living by the imagination of your own heart, and demon spirits play on that. That's where they get their strength to manifest themselves to mankind, because there's light and there's darkness. And the only light, true light, is Jesus Christ and him crucified. Because many things we talk about, why are people so bad and evil? Because we have a sin nature. And unless we're saved from that sin nature, we're going to manifest that sin nature. And the only thing that will take us away from that sin nature is Jesus Christ and him crucified.
There it is, Don.
I yield.
Don in Ohio. Fiery, fiery call, Don. Thanks, brother. I appreciate it, man.
You're welcome.
Yes. Guys, I'm sorry, I ran out of time. I know there's some other callers on the line. I can't get to you. Unfortunately, we ran out. Listen, I'm going through a transition these next weeks. I'm going to be doing some extensive traveling. Okay, so next week we will air a replay for Wisdom Radio. Okay, I won't be live next week. So just keep me in your thoughts and your prayers, making a transition. But Lord willing, we're going to be back in 2 weeks live with new information, guys. Live life, get wisdom, and let it flow. Peace.